Hi everybody, greetings for the day. My name is Tanaya Asgar and I study in 11th standard at Matrix Science Academy. Today, I am here to give you a conceptual knowledge about the topic redox reaction. So let us start. First of all, we will just see the definition of redox reaction. Chemical reactions involving oxidation and reduction occurring simultaneously are known as redox reactions. In this PPT presentation, we are going to study oxidation and reduction in terms of loss or gain of oxygen, loss or gain of hydrogen, transfer of electrons, or changes in the oxidation number. Here is just a summary of what is oxidation and reduction in terms of all these four things. Oxidation is combination of substance with oxygen or loss of hydrogen or loss of electrons or an increase in the oxidation number. Whereas reduction is the removal of oxygen from some substance, gain of hydrogen, gain of electrons, or a decrease in the oxidation number. Oxidation. So we have been studying this term since our childhood. But what are the day-to-day effects of oxidation? For example, aging of apple. This is a special effect known as rancidity, where all the food items containing fats are oxidized such that their smell and the taste changes and they become damaged. So aging of apple is the effect of oxidation. The definition of oxidation process involves all the four aspects that are listed below. Addition of oxygen or electronegative element. For example, magnesium when added to oxygen gas gives us magnesium oxide. Here, oxygen is added to magnesium, so this process is known as oxidation, which forms magnesium oxide. Electronegative elements are mostly the non-metals, for example, the sulfur gas or nitrogen gas or oxygen gas. These are all electronegative. Whenever these elements are added to another elements or compounds, the process is known as oxidation. Second is removal of hydrogen or electropositive element. For example, hydrogen sulfide plus Cl2 gives us HCl plus S. Here, H, that is hydrogen, is removed from hydrogen sulfide. So, this process is known as oxidation. While hydrogen is added to Cl2, so this is reduction, which we will be seeing in the further slides. The third is loss of electrons, that is LOE. You can remember this term with LOE. Here, this is a ferrous ion which has the charge +2. When it loses one electron, it develops one more positive charge on itself and forms Fe+3 ion. This process is also known as oxidation. And the fourth thing is increase in oxidation number. Oxidation number is a concept that we'll be studying in the further slides. So I'll be explaining you the oxidation process in terms of oxidation number in afterwards. The third is reduction. Now, reduction is just opposite to oxidation. Addition of hydrogen or electropositive element is reduction. For example, H2 plus Cl2 gives HCl. Here, H2 is added to chlorine and it forms hydrochloric acid. So, this process is reduction. Removal of oxygen or electronegative element. For example, zinc oxide, which is an amphoteric oxide, plus carbon gives us zinc plus carbon monoxide. Here, oxygen is removed from zinc oxide and it is given to carbon. So here, zinc oxide is reduced while carbon is oxidized. The third is gain of electrons or JER. You can remember it with JER. Gain of electrons. Here Cl2, it has no charge, it has zero charge. So Cl2, and when we add two electrons to it, it becomes 2Cl-. This process is also known as reduction because here Cl2 is gaining two electrons. And the last is decrease in the oxidation number. This is the process of rusting of iron. Here, Fe plus O2 gives us Fe2O3. Here, oxygen is added to ferrous and it forms ferric oxide. This is the process of oxidation. These are some examples involving redox reaction. The first is copper oxide. Copper oxide plus hydrogen gives us copper plus H2O. Here, copper oxide has oxygen and the oxygen is removed from copper oxide and it is given to hydrogen. So hydrogen is oxidized while copper oxide is reduced to Cu. We will be studying about reducing agent and oxidizing agent in the further slides. In the second example, the zinc plus Cu2 plus gives us Zn2 plus plus Cu. Here, the concept of loss and gain of electrons is applicable. Zinc has zero charge. When it loses two electrons, it becomes Zn plus 2. So this is oxidized. While Cu2 plus, when gains two electrons, becomes Cu. So this is reduction. The third example is CH4, that is methane plus oxygen, gives us carbon dioxide plus H2. Here, H, that is hydrogen, is removed from CH4 and it is given to O2. So this is oxidation. While O2 is getting reduced because hydrogen is being added to it. Let us see what is further. This is an oil rig, is a technique by which you can remember that oxidation involves loss of electrons and reduction involves gain of electrons. Here we will be able to understand how the electron transfer leads to oxidation or reduction process. This is the molecule A and this is the molecule B. A has 7 electrons while B has 3 electrons. When we add them, the electrons from A are transferred to B. That is, A loses electrons and B gains electrons. So when it loses electrons, in the product side, it has 3 electrons. This process is oxidation. While the B molecule, it gains some electrons and forms this in the product side, which has more electrons. So this process is reduction. And the A molecule here is acting as the oxidizing agent, while A is acting as the reducing agent and B is acting as the oxidizing agent. So let us see what are oxidizing and reducing agents. Oxidizing and reducing agents are also known as oxidant and reductant respectively. The reactant that reduces an element in another reactant is called the reducing agent. Reducing agent is that reactant which helps the other reactant get reduced. It is that reactant which itself gets oxidized. As you can see in this figure, oxidation and reduction process, this is a figure showing redox reaction. Here, as this has a positive charge, we know that it is losing some electrons, and this has a negative charge, we know that it is gaining electrons. So when this is losing electrons, it is getting oxidized. So this will be treated as a reducing agent. While this is gaining electrons, so it is getting reduced, and this is the oxidizing agent. In short, the oxidizing agent is that reactant which oxidizes the other reactant and itself gets reduced, while the reducing agent is that reactant which reduces the other and itself gets oxidized. Let us see this through an example. Sodium plus chlorine gas gives us sodium chloride. Here, sodium is electropositive, chlorine is electronegative. And this is the product. Here, because chlorine, which is electronegative, is being added to Na, which is electropositive, so this process is oxidation. While electropositive element is being added to chlorine, so this is reduction. So here, Na is acting as the reducing agent and Cl2 is acting as the oxidizing agent. Na is getting oxidized and Cl2 is getting reduced. This is a GIF which shows that loss of electrons means oxidation. And reduction is the gain of electrons. It also shows that fire burns more brightly when it comes in contact with oxygen. This is due to the redox reactions itself. Now let us see the types of redox reactions. Actually, there are three types of redox reactions, but in this slide, we will just see two. First is intermolecular redox reaction and intramolecular redox reaction. Intermolecular redox reactions are those reactions in which the oxidant and reductant, that is oxidizing agent and reducing agent, are part of different molecules. For example, in H2S and Cl2, when we add them, it forms S plus 2HCl. Here, H2S is losing hydrogen, that is, it is getting oxidized. So it is acting as the reductant. And Cl2 is gaining oxygen, so it is getting reduced and it acts as oxidant. So here, oxidizing agent and reducing agent belong to different molecules. And so this is intermolecular redox reaction. The second is intramolecular redox reaction. These are those reactions in which the oxidizing and reducing agents are composed into one single molecule. Let us see an example. In the example below, the reactant is KClO3 and the products are KCl and O2. That is, KClO3 decomposes to form KCl and O2. Here, oxidizing agent is KCl and reducing agent is O3. Why? Because this is based on the concept of oxidation number, which we will be seeing further. This is the third type of redox reaction, that is disproportionation reaction. The redox reactions in which an atom of a molecule or ion undergoes oxidation and reduction simultaneously. In intramolecular redox reactions, oxidizing and reducing agents are composed into one molecule, while here it's just the opposite. The species which undergoes oxidation and reduction is same and belong to the same molecule on the reactant side. For example, H2O2 gives 2H2O plus O2. Here H2O2 is getting reduced to H2O and it is simultaneously getting oxidized to O2. Similarly, in the second example, KClO3 gives KClO4 plus KCl. Here, oxygen is getting added to KClO3 and it is forming KClO4, that is oxidation process is going on, while KClO3 is losing oxygen to form KCl. This is the reduction process. So this is what is disproportionation reaction, in which the species undergoing oxidation and reduction belong to the same molecule on the reactant side. Now comes the concept of oxidation number. Oxidation number is a residual charge which an atom of an element appears to have on it in its bonded form. It refers to the total charge of all the atoms of same kind. For example, in HCl, the oxidation number of hydrogen is plus 1 and that of Cl is -1. This is due to electronegativity difference between the two atoms. Here, chlorine attracts the shared pair of electrons and hence has a negative residual charge on it, and H develops a positive residual charge on it. As we can see in the figure besides, hydrogen and chlorine develop a covalent bond between them. The shared pair of electrons is attracted towards the chlorine and so it develops a charge of negative delta, while oxygen has positive delta. So this is due to electronegativity difference between the two atoms. So oxidation number is the residual charge which is present on hydrogen and chlorine, that is +1 and -1. Oxidation state refers to the per atom, the charge per atom of all the atoms of same kind in a compound. For example, in FeCl3, that is ferrous chloride, the oxidation number of chlorine is -3. But the oxidation state of chlorine is minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. That is, oxidation state is the oxidation number per atom or the residual charge per atom, while the oxidation number is the sum of all the oxidation states of all the atoms of the same kind. Now let us come to the rules for assigning oxidation number. We'll be studying it in two different parts, that is, rules for ionic compounds and rules for covalent compounds. So first, in ionic compounds, oxidation number is simply the charge on the cation and anion. That is, in MgCl twice, that is magnesium chloride. By crisscross method, we know that magnesium has positive 2 and Cl has minus 1 charge. So what does this rule say? That the oxidation number of magnesium is plus 2 and the oxidation number of chlorine is minus 1, which are the respective charges on them. The second rule says that the sum of the oxidation numbers of all the atoms in an ionic compound is equal to 0 or is equal to the charge on them. In the example below, it is equal to 0, but in some cases in ionic in ions, the sum of oxidation numbers of all the atoms is equal to the charge on that whole ion. For example, in calcium oxide, we know that the charge on calcium is plus 2 and on oxygen it is minus 2. So the total of all total of the oxidation number of both comes to 0. When we see the MgCl2 example that we saw above, in that case also the total charge is coming to 0. Now let us see the rules for assigning oxidation number in covalent compounds. So here we have a list of them. The first is elemental form. In covalent compounds, oxidation numbers can't be assigned directly as there is no actual charge. So we need to follow some basic rules. First is, any element in its natural state or free state has oxidation state equal to 0. For example, H2, O2, T4, Fe, S8, all these have 0 oxidation state because they are in their elemental form. The next is atomic ions. The oxidation state of cation and anion is equal to the charge on it. For example, the sulfate ion has charge minus 2. So its oxidation state is also minus 2. Another example is ammonium ion. NH4 plus, it has charge plus 1, so its oxidation state is also plus 1. Now the next rule is group 1 atoms, that is lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, etc. These atoms have plus 1 oxidation state unless in their elemental form, because in elemental form they will have 0 as their oxidation state. But otherwise, in all the cases, the atoms belonging to the first group have plus 1 oxidation number. Now the next rule is group 2 atoms, that is beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium, etc. These have plus 2 unless in the elemental form. Now the next special case is hydrogen. When hydrogen is bonded to a non-metal, its oxidation state is plus 1 because it is bonded to an electronegative atom. While when it is bonded to a metal or an electropositive element, then its oxidation state is minus 1. Now let us see the case of oxygen. This is also a special case. In almost all of its compounds, oxygen has oxidation state as minus 2. While in peroxides, the oxidation state of oxygen is minus 1. For example, in H2O2 or Na2O2, the oxidation state of Na or H is plus 1. So when we calculate the oxidation state of oxygen, it comes to minus 1. This was the case of oxygen. There is one more subcase in oxygen, that is of superoxides. Superoxides like NaO2 or HO2, in these, the oxidation state of oxygen is minus 1/2. Now let us see this case of fluorine. Fluorine is the most electronegative element, and so oxidation state is always minus 1. For example, in PF5, oxidation state of P is plus 5 and that of F is minus 1. In the neutral compounds, the sum of all the oxidation numbers of atoms or ions in a neutral compound is 0. And for ionic compounds, the sum of all the oxidation numbers of atoms in an ionic compound is the charge on the polyatomic ion, as we saw in the previous slide. Now let us see the difference between oxidation state and valency. Valency is the combining capacity of an element, while oxidation state is the residual charge developed due to electronegativity difference. Valency will always be a whole number. Why? Because atoms always combine in simple whole number ratio, while oxidation state might be fractional. For example, in K2S4O6, the oxidation state of potassium is plus 1, oxidation state of oxygen is minus 2, and the sum total of all the oxidation states will come to 0. So it shows that the oxidation state of sulfur in K2S4O6 comes to 5/2, which is a fractional value. Valency is fixed in all the compounds except D block elements. For example, in methane, ethane, or ethyne, or any other compound containing carbon, the valency of carbon remains plus 4. But the oxidation state of carbon in these compounds might change. For example, in methane, the oxidation state of carbon is plus 4, while that in ethane is plus 3, while that in ethyne is minus 1. So oxidation state might be different in different compounds. Now, valency is not assigned as a positive or negative number because it's just a number. It shows the combining capacity. So it cannot be positive or negative. But oxidation state can be positive or negative as it refers to the residual charge. And valency cannot be zero except for some of the noble gases. And oxidation state can be zero because it depends on the compound. These are some important notes that we need to know about calculating the oxidation state or oxidation number. The oxidation state of the most electronegative element in a compound is the least. For example, in sulfuric acid, H2SO4, the most electronegative element is oxygen. So when we calculate the oxidation number of sulfur, we come to know that the oxidation number of sulfur is plus 6. How? Because oxidation number of oxygen is minus 8 and that of hydrogen is plus 2. So oxidation number of sulfur comes to plus 6. By this, we come to know that the oxygen has the least oxidation state in all the three atoms, that is minus 2. So this proves the rule that the oxidation state of most electronegative element in a compound is the least. The second rule is the range of oxidation numbers of elements belonging to certain group is valential electrons to valential electrons minus 8. For example, nitrogen, which belongs to group number 15. The range of oxidation number of nitrogen is plus 5 to minus 3. Why? Because it has 5 valential electrons. And it needs three electrons to complete its octet. So its range is plus 5 to minus 3. While that of chlorine, which belongs to 17th group, the range of oxidation number of chlorine is plus 7 to minus 1. Similarly, we can calculate the range of oxidation number for any atom if we know the group number of that atom. Third rule, if the oxidation number of the central atom exceeds the maximum range, then there will be a peroxy linkage in that molecule. For example, in H2S2O8, the oxidation state of sulfur is plus 1. How? Because oxidation number of oxygen is minus 16 and that of hydrogen is plus 2. So the oxidation state of sulfur is plus 7, which is out of its range because sulfur belongs to 16th group. So its range is plus 6 to minus 2. So plus 7 is greater than plus 6, which is out of its range. Therefore, there will be a peroxy linkage in the structure. There is the structure of H2S2O7 in the neighboring position. Here, the oxygen atoms are bonded to each other, and that is known as the peroxy linkage. Now, redox reactions in terms of oxidation number. As we saw in the first two slides, oxidation is increase in oxidation number and reduction is decrease in oxidation number. In the example besides, we can see that copper oxide plus magnesium gives us copper plus magnesium oxide. Here, the oxidation number of copper in copper oxide is plus 2, while that of magnesium is 0 because it is in its elemental form. In the product side, the oxidation number of copper is 0 and that of magnesium is plus 2. This shows that there is an increase in the oxidation number of magnesium and a decrease in the oxidation number of copper. This shows that magnesium is undergoing oxidation and copper is undergoing reduction. So here, copper oxide is the oxidant or the oxidizing agent, and magnesium is the reductant or the reducing agent. Why? Because these are undergoing reduction and oxidation respectively. This is a GIF which shows us the process of redox reaction through loss of electrons. The Zn atom displaces copper from its copper sulfate solution. This happens because zinc atom loses two electrons, which are gained by the copper atom in the copper ion, which is Cu2+ ion in copper sulfate. When copper ion in copper sulfate gains two electrons, it becomes elemental copper and it is detached from the sulfate ion, and Zn occupies the place of copper. So this is how the reaction takes place. This is the last topic, which is Stokes notation. Stokes notation is the notation used where the oxidation state of an element is represented by the Roman numeral. Here, Stokes notation is only used for those compounds in which the elements have variable oxidation number. For example, the examples listed below are ferric oxide and ferric oxide in the first two cases. Both are ferric oxide, but the oxidation number of iron in both of them are variable. In the first case, it is plus two, so it is showing 2 in Roman numerals. And in the second case, it is plus 3, so it is showing plus 3 in the Roman numerals. These Roman numerals have to be placed after the symbols of elements. If two elements are making more than one compound, then and only then use Stokes notation to show oxidation number of the metal, that is the electropositive element. We have another example of copper oxide. In the first case, the copper oxide has oxidation number of plus 2, which has been shown in the Stokes notation. And in the second case, it has plus 1, which has also been shown in the Stokes notation. So these were some concepts related to redox reactions. I totally feel that this will help you learn something. Thank you.